Today I'm going to walk you through restoring yellowing and aging headlights to their factory fit and finish using a method that will last you for years.
Ladies and gentlemen,
let's go!
Hit it!
Welcome.
Headlights with plastic lenses that have aged to the point where they're yellow from the sun damaging them from the UV. Polishing the headlights doesn't always restore that. As a matter of fact, once it gets bad enough, that doesn't do much for you at that point anymore. And what's interesting is it's the outside part of the lens actually absorbs some of this UV and takes most of the damage. And so it's possible through sanding to remove that layer of oxidation and even some of the pitting and surface cracks if your headlight has those, and then do the polishing process to restore the finish. So we're going to do that on this SVX today, and I'm going to walk you through the entire process. Okay, here are the following tools required to complete today's exercise. You need a sanding block, preferably an assortment of sanding blocks. I actually got out my bodywork tools for this one, so I'm using a DuraBlock set. I highly recommend these. These typically use adhesive-backed sandpaper, and luckily I actually had some in the grit that we will be starting with today. If you don't have that, don't sweat it. You know, just find something that works good for you as a sanding block, because the sandpaper is the most important part. And you'll need, I recommend this 3M stuff. You can get it from Advanced Auto Parts. You can get it from the automotive section at Walmart. And these are wet dry sandpaper. We will be doing wet sanding today. The grits that I'm going to use today will be 320, 600, 800. I might use 1000, but we're gonna use these three grits because the headlights aren't as bad as other ones that I've done. So that's a pretty good medium. Of course, you're going to need a pot of water. Doesn't need to be hot or cold or anything, it just needs to be clean. Water carries away the particles that the abrasive surface picks up, so it's important to keep your sandpaper well lubricated. We'll go over that in a bit. And once you are done sanding, then we're going to move on to the polishing, and there are several different ways that you can go about this. This is actually a cheapo polishing kit that you can get from Harbor Freight. It includes white and brown and the two wheels. Now this is normally for polishing aluminum, and that's the polish that I actually use on this, and this is what works for me. This may not be the professional way to do it, but this is the way that you, the average person at home, can do this and have a nice finish that lasts a long time. So here are some other polishes, and I do actually use this on aluminum when I do intake manifolds and valve covers and stuff. It's the same stuff I use. The important thing is that you have two separate wheels. You have a wheel for your rough cut, and then you have a wheel for your fine. The brown is the rough, the white is the fine. And that's all the basic tools, other than you're going to need a drill. I recommend a corded drill that you don't like so much, because when you're running a drill constantly at high RPM, that's when you start to do things like get the chuck gear train really hot and spits grease out, or you know, you wear out the motor or the brushes or whatever. So get a used drill or something you don't like too much, or if you have air that's, you know, that works for you. Better the tools, better the job. But today you're going to see the results that I can obtain with relatively basic tools. All right, so looking at both of these headlights, the right side looks worse than the left side, the right side being the passenger side if you're in the United States. I'm gonna pick the worst one, so we have to beat the better one, obviously, at the very least. So whatever the end result ends up being, just remember that I picked the crappier one to start with. So here we go. Okay, the first and most important step is to make your work environment work for you. And you do that by gaining access to the subject at hand, to the best of your ability. And in most of my situations, I do the stuff on the vehicle. Some of you might find it advantageous to remove it from your vehicle ahead of time. I'm not going to cover all of that. I'm just going to do it in situ, as if you at home, you know, might want to do, or maybe you live in an apartment complex. Either way, it shouldn't matter where you live. There's nothing better than taking a couple hours of your time and really bettering your odds as far as safety goes. So with that, to get started on this, I've just popped the hood on here to give me a little bit better access up top. I seem to have enough room down on the bottom here, so no big deal. If you have a nice paint job, just plan to wash your car afterwards, because as you'll see, this is going to make a bit of mess. If you have sensitive skin, I definitely recommend putting on a pair of gloves, latex or nitrile, your preference. Okay, so at this point you want to choose what grit you're starting with. I'm choosing to start with 320. You never, under any circumstances, want to start any lower than 220. Maybe even 180, but I would never absolutely go any lower than that. And keep in mind that the lower the grit you start with, the more sanding that you'll have ahead of you. So it's really important to carefully evaluate your situation and make the best choice for the job. If you choose too high of a grit to start with, then you might have pits and cracks in there when you're finished. And really, because of how big some rocks are on the road and everything else, inevitably you're going to have some things that aren't going to come out. So you just really gotta pick and choose. It's the 80-20 rule, as I was once told, right? 80% the bulk of the time gets you 80% of the way, but it might take that entire time all over again to get that last 20%. And so we're just going for the first 80% here. So I've chosen 320 grit to start with. I do have that here in the wet dry paper option that I recommended earlier, but since I have DuraBlocks and the adhesive backed sandpaper, I'm going to go ahead and use that for at least this initial grit. Now the rules to sanding are: wet the paper as much as possible. Sometimes it helps to have a spray bottle. I like to dunk it often. And the other thing is, no swirls. Do not swirl. You sand one direction, unidirectionally. And that'll come into play when we switch to the next grit, because when you go to the next grit, then you have to go 90 degrees, right? So up and down versus straight across. And it's really important that you do not swirl, or you're going to have more swirls to deal with there in the end result. Okay, so we're gonna dip it, and I'm gonna go this way first, and it's gonna take several dips to get the headlight completely covered in water. So we're moving along. You can see the plastic material that's come off already, that yellowish finish. That's actually the UV damaged plastic coming off the top layer there, and so you're going to keep sanding this until that milky colored plastic turns a lighter, less milky color. It'll be more of a clear plastic color. So get a look at that now, and then when I'm finished, we'll come back and I'll show you what the water looks like when we're a little bit deeper in. Okay, so here we are 5 to 10 minutes in on our 320 grit. I have used most of the pot of water, and you can see that the water and the material left behind is a much whiter white. It is not a yellowish tapioca white that we saw earlier, so we are well past the layer. So you want to definitely sand it until it's at least white, but because there were some micro cracks and some pitting, I decided to go that much further. It was white within the first 2 to 3 minutes of sanding. And so I basically gave it another 10 minutes or so total sanding time at this grit before we move on to the next one. So I'll go ahead and finish this out at the 320 grit. And how should you be sanding? You don't have to push very hard. Let the tool do the work. And you gotta save your arms, because you have a lot of sanding ahead of you if you're doing this, so you don't want to push hard and wear yourself out. I haven't had to change the sandpaper. You shouldn't have to change the sandpaper, at least for the initial grit, while you're sitting here going through this. So just remember the rules. Let the tool do the work. Add water often. And don't swirl. Just straight lines. Okay, now that we're done with the 320, I'm going to use the remainder of this water and just kind of rinse this down. I'll get fresh water for the next grit. I also grabbed a towel. We're going to wipe this dry and have a look at the actual surface finish here. I've found that it's much harder to detect the micro cracks and stuff once you started sanding, and they tend to not show up again until you're at the polishing stage. And so you're going to have to be really vigilant and look for those micro cracks. And I guess you can kind of see some here in the top, and I have no idea if that's going to show up on camera, but you'll know it when you see it. So I could go back and sand that more. And once again, this is that 80-20 rule. Look at where the light actually comes out of the housing. These are off to the side here, so I'm not going to worry about those. They're not too deep. Maybe I will finish. I might actually sell these headlights, so maybe I will go back and see if I can get that out. If you were going for a show finish, you know, obviously you'd want to spend a little more time on there. But from what I can tell, I don't see any more of those micro cracks in the middle of the lens, so that's not going to affect our light output. And there's, once again, just a couple of pits here and there. But 15 minutes at 320 grit yielded really good results. So I think this would be okay to move forward. Okay, for the next step, I have got a 2x4 here. This is, I could use a Dura-Black, but this is more or less to demonstrate. You know, you really could just use anything kind of around the house, as long as it's not your fingers. And why shouldn't you use your fingers, you might wonder? Well, when you're pressing on the sandpaper and running it across, you're only getting the areas just below your fingers. And sure, if you, you know, sand enough, you'll get coverage. But the problem is that because you're pushing like this and the pressure has like peak points, you're going to make divots inside this. And remember that that you're polishing is essentially a lens, because light has to pass through and project through it. And you don't want your fingers in there diffracting the light. I guess ultimately it might not make that much of a difference, but certainly for the final fit and finish, you will notice if you don't use a sanding block. All right, so I have my 600 grit. That's our next grit. We went from 320 to 600. If you have 400, then you might want to go that direction. 600 will work. You just sand a little longer. So I'm going to dip it, get it wet, once again, as generous as possible on the water. And since we're on the next grit, and I went horizontally last time, I have to go vertically this time. So now I'm going to sit here and go vertically like this. And how do you know when you're done? Well, when you dry it up, you should only be able to see vertical lines. If you see any horizontal lines at all, then you haven't sanded through all the way, and you need to continue sanding at that grit before moving on to the next one. So you can see I did rub this on here, and there's still horizontal patches going through it. So I'm going to keep on sanding straight vertically. Remember, no swirling. 90 degrees. So we'll come back when I'm done with that. Okay, here's the progress report. I opened the hood so I could get better access for going up and down. And this is a good example of how to tell when you're almost done, but not quite. So because I had the hood open and I'm leaning back like this, I'm not getting the lower part of the headlight as much. And let me see if I can focus in on here. And I have no idea if this is going to show up on camera, but you should see a bunch of vertical lines, at least out here. And then once we get down here and over into here, you'll see that there's still some horizontal lines here. So it looks like the top half of the headlight is definitely ready to go. So I just need to finish through on the bottom here before we move on to the next grit. Here's the 600 grit finished. Notice how there are no horizontal streaks, only the vertical ones from the grit of the sandpaper. Also note how on the rest of the light assembly there's the yellowish appearance, whereas here it is a very light colored appearance with very little yellow hue, if at all. I think these may have had a slight tint to them from the factory, but on a perfectly clear lens, this will be a very light color. Okay, here is the 800 grit complete. So we went from 600 to 800, and I sanded horizontally because 600 was vertically. And we are now ready to polish. Now, if you're going for like a super high quality finish, you may want to just keep sanding. Of course, if you were doing that, you would have purchased a lot more grits of sandpaper and went with every step in between. One thing to note is after you've sanded one direction, like let's say you do what I did and you did your 320 base, as soon as you go to the 600 this way and you start sanding, a lot of micro cracks will make themselves apparent again. So a good way to check for micro cracks would be to sand the next grit vertically a little bit, and when the lens is wet, that does reveal the micro cracks, and on this light there will be some here along the top. Okay, here we go with the polishing. I'm gonna start with the rough wheel first, which is for our brown. So we're gonna put that in the drill. This is our brown, and so you'll want to load the wheel up with some polish and go on the headlight. Now remember, there are several rules to this. Don't touch the bolt or the screw head or whatever to the headlight, because that'll obviously damage it severely. And you don't want to stay in one place. You want to continuously move around and check the temperature of the plastic, because if you stay in one place, you're going to melt the plastic. You get the whole headlight too hot, you're going to melt the plastic. If the headlight is too hot to hold on to, then it's too hot and you should take a break and let things cool down for a little bit. So here we go. Okay, so here's a little close-up shot. This is the rough cut polish. This is 800 grit sandpaper. You can see it's really starting to bring out the shine. And you would see a really big difference if this was a completely clear lens, because this has stuff in it to refract the light and distribute it different directions. You're not going to have that completely clear effect. Okay, here we go with the white rouge and finishing wheel. So here is that end result after the final polishing rouge. Just went over this with some glass cleaner and wiped it off. And as you can see, it's not completely perfect, but it looks much better than it did. And remember how we picked the worst two of the headlights? There's that before headlight for you. Barely see what's going on in there compared to now.